Welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast Show, Espresso on SABC3. It's a beautiful Thursday morning, but as you know, Wednesday nights on SABC3 are action-packed with the ultimate Brime Master. And unfortunately, last night was another elimination round, and Team Spectacular got chopped off, but they join us this morning to celebrate a great journey and what they've learned, and they're going to share some of those skills with us. Lebo and Nono, good morning. How are you, Team Spectacular?
Morning.
It's great to have you here. Are you still tired a little bit this morning?
Sure, no.
Just kind of getting
used to it.
All right. But congratulations on getting as far as you did. I mean, what a challenging experience it was. Tell me about your experience, Lebo. How was it being part of the Ultimate Brime Master?
Wow. Being part of Ultimate Brime Master was like a life-changing experience. I mean, we got to do things that we never thought we'd ever do in our lives. We got to meet people we never thought we'd meet. I mean, we made friends with a gay couple from McGregor.
The Wine Valley.
Yes, yeah. I never thought that I would meet people from there, you know? It was amazing. Our lives have changed because of Brime Master. The way that I view a bri to how I used to view a bri before Brime Master is totally different now.
So first it was just about chesanya manana, all these good things.
Yeah, fantastic. All these amazing things.
And I understand, Nono, that when you got into the competition, you were actually a bit of the underdog team. People didn't really regard you as a force to be reckoned with.
Of course, people didn't regard us as a force to be reckoned with, as you say, because they just looked at two ladies, two African ladies. But we got there and we broke the barrier, and we showed that it can be done by anyone.
Sisters are doing it for themselves.
That's us.
Loving it.
Yeah,
While we're at it, let's just quickly jump into the dish that you're creating for us today. What are you making?
We're making a stir fry with noodles. Mm-hmm. And then Nono is busy making some salmon steak there. I mean, this is just something
tuna.
Light.
Tuna steak. Yeah, which is going to go with the wasabi mayo.
Yeah.
And that's actually what we did in Sodwana. After catching the biggest fish.
Yeah. So you actually caught a fish.
The biggest fish.
You caught
the biggest fish. Of course we did. Sisters are doing it. Representing. That is so cool.
Yeah.
All right, so the preparation, you've gone in with the vegetables in there. Yeah. You also had was there some garlic involved there?
There's some garlic, some ginger, some good stuff. And some peppers, green beans and some carrots.
Yes.
And some spring onions.
Lovely stuff.
Yeah, got some coriander here as well to give it a nice, fresh, taste to it.
Yes. Tell me about what was the biggest challenge for each of you personally during the Ultimate Brime Master competition?
Sure. You know, there were so many challenges that we actually faced. Also considering that a lot of the things that we did was new to us. You know, like fishing, camping, and stuff that we've never done.
Mm-hmm.
So everything, you know, was a challenge, but I think we did well overall because we came out of our comfort zone. We did what most people would battle with, cooking food on an open fire.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's trying to control the heat. It's imagining and monitoring that heat. It is 180 degrees. Because when you open a stove, it's simple.
Yeah.
But when it's open fire, it's another story altogether.
That's actually very true.
You know, so we got to bake bread and butter pudding, best bread and butter pudding that Label did. You know, we got to do cook sisters. We did, you know, we had so many best dishes and we actually are very proud of ourselves.
Yeah. So now that you're back home, I'm sure the families are like, woo, bana, kipes TV, and now you must just cook for the whole family. Is that what the feeling is like when you get back home now?
You don't understand. Like, people are saying they're coming over for Christmas bride.
Like,
I'm like, people, I stayed in the bushes for 2 months. Can somebody else just
cook
bride for a
me,
change?
You know? Yeah.
And of course, the big reward at the end of the day that you guys came up with, 75 big ones.
Yeah,
oh, wow.
75 babies.
Have you already blown it?
Not yet. We're going to invest it back into our businesses.
Okay.
So, yeah.
What businesses are you running? Tell
Queen
me a bit
Catering,
more.
Both of us.
Yes.
I co-own a coffee shop with my cousin.
I just need to back out from, because the tuna's about to go cray. Already it's starting to pop. Okay.
Yeah, it is.
By the way, if you'd like to learn how to make this recipe that the ladies are doing for us, then SMS the keyword tuna to 33728. We're making a lovely stir fry with a tuna, what do you call it, tuna?
It's a tuna steak.
All right, cool. So
and
tuna to 33728. So you were telling me about your business. So you're both in catering.
Yeah, we're both in catering.
Mm-hmm.
I co-own a coffee shop, but then I also have another company on the side that does catering for functions and stuff like that, because the coffee shop's only Monday to Friday, 8 to 4. So yeah, I do gourmet bries after Ultimate Brime Master.
What?
And I think Ultimate Brime Master just has a way of bringing out the flavor in a person. We've got to find ourselves.
I like that. It's got a way of bringing out the flavor in a person. I like that you are all, you know, so geared into your businesses. But the elimination, obviously a very, very sad part of it. Mm-hmm. What were your feelings when after this long journey, you really, really nearly reached the finals and you were eliminated? What was the feeling there?
Sure, the feeling was, you know, it was a very emotional period for us, and it was a very emotional day because you know, we worked so hard and we really felt that we gave it our best, you know. But also we understand that it is a competition, there can only be one winner.
That is so true.
And we knew that from the beginning. So as long as we gave our best and we were happy with what we gave, we're okay, you know.
So do you feel you live true to your mantra that says, cook with soul, love what you do, and the rewards will follow?
Definitely, we did that. And, you know, we didn't hold anything back. We have no regrets. We gave it our best, and, you know, that's all that matters.
That is absolutely fantastic. Congratulations, guys. I can't wait to taste this.
It looks
like. So how do you plate it up? The tuna is nice and seared on both sides. You didn't overcook it. You left that little pink strip in the middle.
I didn't overcook because tuna, you know, you can eat it raw. You can eat it like this, just sear it on the outside. You don't want to overcook it because...
So have a good look at that tuna.
Yeah, so you can still see some of that pink inside. That's one thing that we learned from the Prime Master.
Yes.
Yeah, so Levi's just doing a stir fry.
Levi, the other day I was having noodles with a stir fry as well, and I was wondering, how do they prepare them to keep them saucy but not overcook them? So is it about being quick? So very hot pan, and then you just go very quickly with your ingredients.
Yeah, absolutely. You need a very hot pan and go very quickly with the ingredients, and make sure that your vegetables still have that nice crunch to it.
Yes.
You know, it should not be dead and lumped. It should be a nice, refreshing meal.
Lovely stuff. Well, we're going to plate this up, and just very quickly, that keyword once again is tuna to 33728. But if you're wondering how we got to this point, take a look at this. We're going to make it look pretty for you.
Sear tuna, then season and dress with lemon juice. Heat oil and stir fry garlic, ginger, spring onion, peppers, carrots, and beans. Stir in soy sauce, sweet and sour sauce, salt, pepper, and noodles. Mix together mayo, wasabi, and lemon juice. Serve sliced tuna on top of stir fry, then drizzle with sauce.
And there we are, making it look very, very pretty for you. The last pieces of tuna going on. The keyword is tuna, that you SMS to 33728, and we'll send on the recipe list as well as the ingredient list that you can try out at home and entertain the family over the festive season. Look at that. Just imagine serving that up for a braai, hey? Ladies, you have truly, truly impressed. Look at that. What is that? Mayonnaise?
It's a wasabi mayo. It's basically your mayo.
Yeah.
With wasabi, so it gives it that nice
little bite.
That nice little bite, because tuna is like that. It needs that little spiciness.
Look at you ladies being all gourmet. Let's just put it out front here. Look at that. Just turn it around, and there you have it. Absolutely beautiful. Well, ladies, once again, congratulations for getting this far in the competition.
Thank you.
And I wish you all the success and good luck for the future with your businesses. I'm sure that you're going to do
very,
very well.
Thank you very much. For sure, great things are still yet to come.
Fantastic. Team Spectacular here on Expresso. Remember to watch Ultimate Braai Master on Wednesday evenings at 8:30 on SABC3. And this is what you can expect in the next episode.
Next time on the Ultimate Braai Master.
Today I'm not going to stop. The pain is going to continue coming and coming and coming.
Dustin's mean, eh?
He's very mean.
He really is, eh? It's going to be a little rough for them.
It's pretty crazy.
We are indeed spinning.
Jeez, I'm even nervous for these eggs, man.
The challenge is pretty much pushing us.
It's not supposed to be easy.
So much going on, and you're hoping not to mess something up.
Anyone could win this.
No. I'm going to miss this.
By supporting businessmen like Sibusiso Tshabalala and his Berry Hill Trading Company, that's where we found goodness. Pick n Pay, always there for you.